Hey folks, it's Brian and it's time for Jeep video number 56. So I'm gonna be working on this valve cover gasket. Pretty sure it's worn the hell out. There's a bunch of oil seepage around it. All I'm gonna commit to right now is getting it off. Let's just see where that gets us. All right, so you will need a 7/16 inch socket. I'm gonna use the driver because I'm lazy. It is substantially easier to do this with the engine out of the vehicle. And it's a good idea to have a magnetic bolt holder. It will save you a lot of hassle later on. All right, so that's the easy part. Got a couple of, there's a hose holder over here and you should just come off if you lift straight up. There it goes, and it drops into two pieces, not a big deal. Just put it back together. The bottom piece of it should just unscrew and go right back in. Okay. So if you're dealing with that and it comes apart, don't panic. This may be a little bit more challenging. I've had those come apart on me in a bad way, so I'm going to use this to see if I can encourage it to pop up. Okay, so it appears there are two little clamps in there, and if you just push them apart, it'll come up. All right, let's see if these are the same size. We've got a stud in the center. All right, it is. So there's a stud in the center next to the oil cap. And there's one in the back corner. This one just has a nut. Okay, and let's see if we can get this Tupperware off here. So I'm gonna separate it. Oh, there's a second nut. So it has three of the damn things. That's why it wouldn't come up. No idea. I'm going to use some WD-40 to clean it because I really can't tell what I'm looking at. Putting on a new set of gloves, what I'm looking at. All right, so one of them is on here. So I'm going to try and use a screwdriver because I think this is another little tab. Yeah, that's sure what it looks like. So I think it takes two screwdrivers to get that one loose. Just so happens that I have a couple screwdrivers. And I, you know, I don't understand their fascination with these little clips and clamps that you can't. Alright, so if you just wiggle it, it appears to come loose. There we go. Still have no idea what was holding that on. It's filthy. So I'm going to set it on the ground. And filthy is the understatement on this. And I really don't see a reason for their... So I got oil seepage here and got oil seepage there, so I want to replace both of those. I mean, this is a shit show up here. Might not even be the valve cover gasket. Might just be those. So there is a stud there in the back corner. There's one here, and I'll bet that one's a stud too. Air conditioning clamp is in the way. It is a 13/16 is what it says. No, that is not a 13/16. Ain't no way. Let's try a 3/4. No, it's smaller than that too. Let's see if 11/16 fits it. Like a charm. Alright. Alright, that should get me clear, and the problem was it was hanging up between the heater and that. So, I'm going to set this dirty, nasty thing here. Okay, so your valve cover gasket should not be flat. Like this. That does nothing for nobody. You'll notice I change gloves quite frequently. Gloves are cheap. So I want to get a feel for the engine, and I'm going to check out the valves while I'm in here, because this is otherwise not that big of a deal to do. I'm going to spin the valve guides, or at least the ones that aren't under compression. Alright, so I've got two that I've got one that I can't spin, and another one that I can't spin because these are both being compressed. Not holding oil, but remember I had this engine upside down very recently. And beyond that, and it being filthy, everything else looks okay. So we're just going to fold the space blanket up out of the way. This is really nasty. It's been leaking for a long time in here. So, yeah, I'm going to see what I can do to clean this up. You want to use care not to sweep anything into the engine. As they say, nothing good will come of that. The factory manual says to use cloth cleaner. I don't know what the hell that is. Fabric cleaner is what it says. I'm assuming that that is acetone. It's not a good idea to have a whole bunch of oily buildup next to your engine. And basically, between the valve cover, or I mean the intake manifold gasket and the edge of the valve cover is just caked with oil and grease and nastiness. almost there. Just a lot of junk in here. One more little piece that uses up the last of the paper towels. Time for another roll of paper towels. So this gasket is completely flat. It's toast. Okay, so there are little grommets in here and they need to come out. I guess the easiest way to get them out is going to be this. I'm using a very lightweight hammer, so it doesn't do a lot. You can also pop them out. All right, so these are, again, these are shop. These are supposed to be rubber donuts that are flexible. Ain't nothing flexible about these. (Clears throat) just nothing flexible about that. Which is why it's been leaking, because those are actually what hold the valve cover in place. And Jeep calls this a cylinder head cover, which is actually, I wouldn't argue against that. That's a factually accurate name for it. But you can see it's been leaking for a long time because there is residue all around this cover. So now at this point we want to get as much out of here as possible. Really shouldn't be anything in here, but there is. There's some varnish and some other nastiness that has built up inside this cover. Brown shit that's coming out of here. That is oil residue that should not be in this engine. Your oil should not leave stains. All right. One more wipe down. Set of gloves, put the cap back on the acetone because we're done with it. Actually, I'll just bring gloves over. Alright, so I bought a Felpro set of, or a valve cover gasket set. So we've got a fresh set of grommets and a lovely, lovely gasket. So you can see this is way more pliable than what was in there. That should be a world of difference. All right, and because this is still greasy, nasty on the outside, I'm going to go ahead and put gloves back on. So these are a different design. Give me just a second. Okay, so these just snap in. This is what they should have used to begin with. I'm wondering if I reuse the metal pieces, though. That's something I'm going to have to check here in a minute. I'm going to go check the internet once I snap all of these in. I can't imagine that I wouldn't reuse the metal pieces. In which case, I'm going to be digging in the trash here in a minute. All right, I'm going to go check and see what's going on with these metal pieces. Okay, so the interwebby majagget, or the interwebby thing, says a couple things. Apparently, one side of this says, valve cover this side. Nope. Not that I can see. There are holes here, so it's keyed, so I do have it the right direction. And apparently you do reuse the little metal sleeves, so I gotta fish all those out of the fucking trash. Yeah, that sucks. And in the meanwhile, I don't really have somewhere to set this greasy ass piece of shit. So I'm going to set it right here while I fish out the grommets. All right, I'm not going to make y'all watch me fish. Okay, so some of these are really crusty, but you can usually get a screwdriver in under here. All right, this is a crusty one. The crusty one's split in half when you try to take this off, so I'm going to do it here. Okay, so that's an indicator that these really should have been changed a while back, because they're coming across. It's supposed to be rubber. It's not supposed to be plastic. Yeah, that's a crusty one that the heat got to, and it just split it in half. They just pop in once you get the metal out. Who knew that the metal was reusable? So there's 14 of these. I spared you guys quite a bit. That one's somewhat pliable. This one's going to be tough. All right, I'm going to recount 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11, 12, 13, 14. Oh, there's 15, so I'm missing one of these damn things. Fun for me. I gotta go dig in the trash. Alright, so the other thing you can do... Trying not to get stabbed. Pliers. Try this way. All right, I'm gonna fix this. As if you had any doubt that this was going to be a tough one that was baked on. I mean, that's no more rubber than a piece of plastic. So I got to go find one more of these. So I'm going to pause the camera while I go dig in the trash and hunt for it. All right, that one wasn't too bad. Wasn't too hot either, but it wasn't too bad. All right, so... this point, that goes on, and it looks like these threads are the same. So we got one there, one here, then one in the middle on this side. Bunch of bolts. Tell you what, it is a lot easier to work on this with it on an engine stand. It's so convenient. Access is so easy. Okay. And it helps that I'm in a brightly lit workshop with air conditioning. Because, yeah, it was 100 degrees outside again today. Alright, so. These are very low torque settings. So I'm going to hand tighten them. Finger tighten them, and then I'll get out a torque wrench. Seminary Cal that there is a specific sequence that these should be torqued in, so I will go and look that up in a minute. Alright, let me go stop and look that up. I'll be right back. Okay, there is a sequence. You start here and go around. So, it's 85 inch pounds. That's really, really small. So let me get set up and we'll get to it. All right, so I'm going to turn this to where I can see it. I need a deep socket. Alright, I gotta dig for that. Okay, so we're gonna get down to business here. I don't have a 7/16 quarter inch drive deep, so those will just have to be done by hand. And what it feels like is going on is it's bottoming out the metal piece and then just snugging it. Lost track of where I was there. Okay, so when I get to a I'm just snugging them. So you'll feel it bottom out. So we got one left here, and I think center out's the key with this. I don't think the spiral pattern doesn't match the bolts. So now I'm going to recheck everything. That looks good. At least to me it does. Now, grease muffin can go back in its place. So grease muffin goes back here. Only catch is I want to deal with this, so I'm going to leave this loose because I need to replace this ground clamp. And then this goes on the stud on next to the oil cap. It should just snap in. Yep, it just pushes in. And then this piece of shit goes here. So we're essentially done. These need to be replaced. That is not tonight's project. These are nasty, messy. I mean, I can see they've been leaking, so they absolutely need to be replaced. I'll figure out how to get them out of here in a minute, and I pray to God nothing falls in there. But if it does, I know how to get the valve cover off. So anyway, I'm going to research that, and that's it for tonight's video. I'm going to tuck this insulation blanket back in. It honestly looks like it's toast. It looks like a fire starter blanket. But, you know, here we are. We're just going to tuck it back in place and hope for the best. It's covered with grease and oil, and that can't be good. I might look to see if I can find one of these. And if I can, I'm going to replace it because that was nasty. Anyway, that's it for tonight's video. Thanks for watching. I hope that this helps somebody with their project and definitely worth using the Felpro gasket. Check the description for links to the parts. And as always, thanks for watching. Remember to subscribe, like, hit the bell. Let me know what you think in the comments.